I hope you have completed the last sentence that hence the facultative pond is the best suited and used for treatment of sewage. Okay. And hence most of the stabilization ponds in India are in a facultative in nature. Okay. So that part we have finished in the last lecture. Now I told you the further part that we will go to design the we'll solve the design problems, but due to unavailability of board I have not taken that part for today's lecture, but we'll go through the design considerations. I will explain you copy from the slide, and then we'll start the next point also, and in the next lecture I will cover both the design problems. Okay, so please consider this. Now the design considerations for the oxidation pond. Oxidation pond layout, you might have understood. The oxidation pond can be designed for the decomposition of organic waste in presence of oxygen, in absence of oxygen, or at heterogeneous condition. Okay. Now how it can be constructed? That we will write down the design considerations. So first design consideration is about the surface area. The amount of oxygen can be produced by photosynthesis and the BOD that can be satisfied per unit area of the facultative pond depends mainly on the quantum of sunlight falling on the pond site. Falling on the pond site. It's a elevation above mean sea level, time of year, and sky clearance. And hence, the surface area should be in the range of 0.5 to 1 hectare. What are the factors affecting on while considering the surface area of the oxidation pond or the stabilization pond? That is, how much amount of sunlight is getting penetrated? What is the mean sea level? And what is the elevation about the mean sea level? Then the time of year, what period it is working, and what is the sky clearance period of year? Dagaal vatavaran asel tar availability of sunlight will be less, so less penetration of sunlight up to the bottom, and there will be less growth of aquatic plants, and in turn the availability of oxygen in that particular pond will be less. Accordingly, each and every factor will affect on the by considering all these factors, you should go for the decide the surface area. But a thumb rule says you that surface area must be in the range of 2.5 to 1 hectare. It is in a hectare. Understood? So such a different design considerations we should consider, and then we can go to design the oxidation pond. Okay, so first design criteria you can note down from this slide, please. Surface area, that is surface area. You can write down complete slide if you wish, or otherwise if you wish to note down only the design parameter as a the surface area must in the range of 0.5 to 1 hectare. Either of the thing you can go for. The liberty is to your CEO. I will give you 2 minutes to go for this slide.
Okay. Shall we move to the next one or shall we wait?
Please, someone can text me a message or someone can talk. Do you want me to continue for the next point? One thing you should remember, that surface area should be in the range of 0.5 to 0.1 hectare. Okay. Someone has written message. Let me check. Completed, ma'am. Mayuri. Okay. Thank you. May I go for the next bit? Okay. Then we'll see the second. Now, second parameter is the BOD loading. Is it BOD loading? You understood. Is it? What is the BOD loading? Amount of BOD applied to this particular, coming into that particular sewage. Is it? So as per the BOD loading, as per the degree of latitude, you can decide the load of BOD. Is it? So BOD loading for stabilization pond, the table is provided here. Latitude in degree north, you know the latitude can be measured in a degree north or latitude in degree south, north to south, that is the measurement unit. Then areal of BOD loading or organic loading in kg per hectare per day. Is it kg per hectare per day? What is allowed? It is telling to you at what degree of latitude, how much amount of BOD loading will be sustainable for that particular stabilization pond. Otherwise, the degree of latitude is 36 and you are providing 325 of BOD loading. What will happen? That pond will not sustain for the decomposition of that much organic load in that particular tank. Is it? Accordingly, you need to change. Means that temperature effect will be observed over here. Is it? Penetration of sunlight. So these values are applicable for towns at sea level, and when the sky is clear for nearly about 75% of the days in a year. Barabar hai? Generally, apply area madhe 75% of the period is having the sky clearance. Is it? Very few we are having the cloudy season. When there is a cloudy, less availability of sunlight, and wind also blows very slowly. And that meteorological parameters we can say. So these meteorological parameter affects on the decomposition rate of stabilization pond. So we have to take it into consideration. So as per the latitude, what should be the BOD? In a design problem, latitude may be given to you or the BOD loading may be given to you. Accordingly, you can go to design the, solve the further problem. Okay. So while solving the problem, you may understand the importance of these parameters. Okay. So if you are not understanding that much, you please copy it. While solving the problem, I will explain once again on the board. So to make you clear conceptually. So please copy this BOD loading of stabilization ponds.
Shall we move to the next point? Can someone reply me? कंप्लीटेड और नॉट झालं तर झालं नाही तर नाही काहीतरी सांगा प्लीज. हॅलो ओके थँक्यू शीतल. समवन शुड रिप्लाय. आय शुड आय कॅन टेक अझम्पशन दॅट एव्हरीबडी इज रिप्लाईंग. Okay, good. Thank you, Akanksha. Only girls are replying. Why boys are not replying? Boys are not writing or boys are not attending the class? Okay, now the correction factor for elevation. The elevation, sir, MSL, mean sea level. According to the mean sea level, we need to apply the correction factor. Is it? And for also for the sky clearance. The values may be modified for elevation above mean sea level by dividing by a factor 1 plus 0.003 elevation, where elevation is the EL is the elevation of the pond site above the mean sea level in 100 meters. It is given in a 100 meters. When the sky is clear less than 75% of the days in a year, correction factor may be applied at the a rate of 3% for a fall of every 10%. जर 65% एवढा जर स्काय क्लिअरन्स तुम्हाला मिळाला एखाद्या वर्षात. ऍक्च्युली जनरली आपल्या भागात तरी नसतो बट इट मे बी देअर फॉर द व्हेरियस रिजन अँड यू शुड थिंक अबाउट ऑल ओव्हर एरिया. सो इफ इट इज 65% सो वॉट विल बी द फॅक्टर हाऊ विल हॅव टू गो फॉर मीन स्काय इज क्लिअर लेस दॅन 75% ऑफ द डेज in a year, the correction factor may be applied at the rate of 3% for a fall of every 10%. जर तुम्हाला स्काय क्लिअरन्सचा एखादा फॅक्टर दिलेला असेल त्या स्काय क्लिअरन्सच्या फॅक्टर मधून तुम्हाला 3% शुड बी रिमूव्ह. ओके फॉर द एव्हरी 10%. जर 65% असेल तर 3%, 55% असेल तर 6%. Accordingly, you need to change. So that you need not write directly, that factor will be given to you in a design problem. So no worry more about this point. But for your knowledge, you should know that these two correction factors we need to apply. Which two? One is for the elevation and another is for the sky clearance. Okay, I will go to the next point. Now, detention period. How long that water should be remain in that particular pond, that is not the name but the detention period. A drop of sewage entered into the tank and the same drop of sewage left from the tank, whatever period it was remained in, that is nothing but the detention period or detention time, you can say. The removal of BOD in the pond follows a unimolecular pattern. And that is nothing but that detention period. किती दिवसात ते डिकम्पोज होऊ शकतं. सो दॅट फॉर्म्युला इज नथिंग बट टी इज इक्वल टू 1/PT लॉग टू द बेस 10 ऑफ इन टू ब्रॅकेट LA/LA इन टू एल सॉरी इट शुड बी LA/LE. नो इट इज करेक्ट LA/LA मायनस LR. LA इज नथिंग बट द इन्फ्लुएंट BOD अँड LR इज नथिंग बट द BOD रिमूव्ह फ्रॉम दॅट पर्टिक्युलर टँक. And LE is nothing but BOD remain in the effluent. The way we have discussed for the trickling filter or activated sludge process. Same here, LA applied BOD, LR removed BOD, LE remained BOD in a effluent after treatment process. Okay, so this also you will understand properly when while solving the problem. then PT. PT is, I request you simultaneously, you are you can copy this formula. Yeah, PT is nothing but the BOD removal rate constant for a pond at a temperature T in a degree Celsius. If it is given the temperature in a degree Celsius, that is T. For BOD removal rate constant for the pond at temperature T in a degree Celsius. And small t is nothing but the detention period in a days, not in hours. We should note down that units also. Accordingly, these thumb rules are designed. Okay, or we can say what type of formula that empirical formulas are designed. Okay, so detention period, amount of time it can be, what is the amount of time is required to get the complete decomposition or required desired decomposition of that particular tank, that can be determined by using this formula. Please note down this formula. You may be feeling little boring, but while solving problem, you will enjoy this session. Okay. In the next lecture, we will schedule the solving of the problems. And also you will understand properly that how this clearance factor is applied, how this detention time is being calculated and else. Okay. If it is done, may I go to the next point? Okay, done. Shall we go to the next point? Someone has written message completed, but I don't know whether it is written now or earlier messages. Okay, I will assume that it is completed. Continuation with that, the removal rate coefficient at 20 degree Celsius, that is P20. The P kaya apla. So you saw here P is nothing but the BOD removal rate constant for the pond at temperature in degree Celsius. Okay, if the temperature is given in a degree Celsius, you should follow that formula. Otherwise, you need to convert that degree Fahrenheit temperature into degree Celsius, and then you can solve. Okay. The removal rate coefficient at 20 degree Celsius, that is P20, is found to be approximately 0.1 per day. The removal rate constant at other temperature in degree Celsius may be determined by using the following formula. And that formula is nothing but PT is equal to P20 into bracket 1.047 raised to T minus 20. T is nothing but the temperature in degree Celsius. And P20, what you should take here, P20, that 0.1. okay, so accordingly, for whatever time, whatever period, whatever temperature it is being asked, suppose here given to you, I will give one example. Suppose it is given to you here the temperature 30 degree Celsius. Okay, here it is given to you 30 degree Celsius temperature, means you are supposed to find the P30. okay,
P30. How we can find out P30? Simply by keeping the value of P20 as 0.1. Okay, then as it is formula here, and at this place, at this T, you can keep the 30. Okay, sorry, I don't have a slate. I'm trying to draw it with the board. Okay, simply you can go with this way and you can find out the PT. Understood? Once again, I will go back to make you understand once again. Everything is easy while you will understand easily while solving the problem. Here, imagination you may find difficult. Okay? Detention period kadaycha hai tumhala. Is it detention period? T, small t you are need to determine. And for that purpose, final formula is 1 is equal to 1 upon pt log to the base 10 into bracket. LA upon LE. Barabar hai? LA you are knowing, LE you are knowing. Or if with respect to LR it is asked, that is also you are knowing. Is it? Now, PT, you need to calculate only PT. How to calculate that PT? By put, you are knowing about the temperature. Is it? And if you are knowing about the temperature, you can determine the PT by using this formula. Okay? So please write down this slide. Okay, shall we move? Hello guys. Kiti monotonous vatte majhyas bajune mi fakta bolaycha ani te board var tari thoda bara vatta karan tumhi loka thoda tari respond karta board var shikavtana ithe tar ajibat respond karat nahi. Sagle loka vichar kay kartat ki online learning kiti hectic ahe, mulanna kiti tras hotoy. कधीतरी आमच्या वजनी पण बघा आम्हाला किती त्रास होतो टीच करायला, काहीच समोर नसताना बडबडत राहायचं वेड्यासारखं. आणि त्यात कधीतरी बोला म्हणून तुम्हाला एक रिक्वेस्ट केली तर तुम्ही पण बोलत नाही. हाऊ डेंजरस इट इज यू कॅन इमॅजिन, ऑर यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू इमॅजिन, यू वॉन्ट टू एन्जॉय. I will go to the next point. Now depth of pond, optimum range of depth for oxidation pond must be in the range of 1 to 1.5 meter. Surface area kiti hota koni tari sangel ka mala to mage java lagal slides he karayla. Surface area 0.5 to 1 hectare. And now depth, you are talking about depth and it is in meter, that is 1 to 1.5 meter. Sludge accumulation, please note down that. Sludge accumulation, it should be 0.05 to 0.1 meter cube per capita per day, per year, sorry. Tar tya particular tank madhe sludge accumulation rate kay asla pahije tar 0.05 to 0.1 meter cube per capita per year, is it? Sludge accumulation rate, in the sense of sludge generation rate from that particular village or small town should be in the range of 0.05 to 0.1 meter cube per capita per year, is it? In fact, you can think that, you can start thinking in a reverse manner. Sludge accumulation rate you are knowing, and accordingly all other design factors you can take. Okay, then pond size length to width ratio should be in the range of 1.5 to 1. 1.5 to 1, 1.5 to 1, 2, 3 to 1, okay, that range. Then depth between 1 to 1.5 meter, that we have written already. Then free board may be about 1 meter. What is free board? So the level of wastewater above, when you are considering full level, above that there should be availability of free board as 1 meter. Okay, so it can, it must be above, means if you want to have the depth of tank as 1.5 meter, in that case you need to construct that tank for 2.5 meter deep by considering 1 meter as a free board. So please write down. Okay, shall we go to the next point? Okay, these are the various design parameters you should know while designing the oxidation pond. I told you in a environmental engineering, you are supposed to assume a lot of data for designing a particular tank. Okay, so for that purpose, we have taken this part. Actual design problem we will solve in the next lecture. As I told you, the difficulties in today's lecture. Because of that, we are not continuing with this. But in the next lecture, we will continue. We will solve the design problem. Okay. Now, I will move to the next point, that is oxidation ditch. Okay. I told you this chapter is divided into two parts. First part is the low cost treatment, and first part is the anaerobic treatment, and second part is the low cost treatment. So low cost treatment can be performed by different ways. First one we have studied, that is oxidation pond, or we can say it is a stabilization pond. And now the second one we are going to study, that is oxidation ditch. So what is the difference between oxidation pond and oxidation ditch? You can understand while studying the oxidation ditch. Okay, and the last one treatment is a septic tank. So now we will concentrate towards the oxidation ditch. Oxidation pond and oxidation ditch are very grateful methods. Naturally, they are decomposing the organic waste with a low cost. So you can see figure of oxidation ditch. It is usually oval in shape. You can construct here multiple ovals you are observing. You can construct a single, or you can construct multiple ovals in one. Okay. So here it is in an oval shape. This is a wall.
okay, this is a center for divination purpose. This will, if your requirement is having a three O-hole, three oxidation ridge, in that case, better to go with this. It will save your area requirement, is it? So if you want to go for single, so everywhere you need to go for this divination part. So it will save your time. And this part, are you able to observe my cursor? So this is nothing but the aerators. These are the aerators provided. In a oxidation pond or stabilization pond, which we have studied earlier till now, in that no any equipment, no any artificial equipment we have used. A completely natural process where decomposition of organic material can be performed, is it? But here in an oxidation ditch, it is an extended aeration tank. I can say oxidation ditch is an extended aeration tank or extended activated sludge process. In an activated sludge process, in one tank, we are aerating, then sending it to the second tank where settling will be there. And from that active part, we are active part of microorganism, we are recirculating, and again the decomposition process will perform. So here, we are not providing separate tank, but we can go for that also. So here aerators are provided. Horizontal aerators are there. And these aerators will not only provide the air to this sewage, but also it will provide, make that sewage to remain in a suspension form up to the required time. Okay. हे काय होतं की एरिएटर रोटेट करतात ते कसे रोटेशन असणार आहे समजा हे इथं दिस विल बी द डायरेक्शन टू रोटेट ओके सो व्हाइल रोटेटिंग इट विल मूव फॉरवर्ड दॅट सीवेज मटेरियल अँड ऑल्सो दॅट विल मेक टू रिमेन दॅट सीवेज इन अ सस्पेन्शन फॉर्म बिकॉज इन अ ॲक्टिवेटेड स्लज प्रोसेस द डिकम्पोजिशन प्रोसेस इज द सस्पेंडेड ग्रोथ प्रोसेस इट इज नॉट द अटॅच्ड ग्रोथ प्रोसेस So how the proper growth process, it should remain in a suspension form, in a suspended growth process. So this aerator will work two way. One is providing air to the sewage and another is making that sewage to remain in a suspended form. Okay, this figure you might have seen. I will go to the next figure. For your better understanding, I have added many number of figures, but which you want to, you should draw, that I will tell you, okay? See here, this figure is little blur, but you can understand, I will tell you. You just watch through. This is a oxidation ditch. It is always in a oval shape. I will erase the part which I have drawn. Okay, this is a oval shaped tank. Sewage is coming to the first tank, and here you can provide screening if required. Generally, we are providing, and then sewage will be applied to this particular tank. आणि इथं ब्लॅक होलमध्ये आणि इथं एक ब्लॅक होलमध्ये तिथे काय तर एरिएटर्स आहेत हा एरिएटर दिस इज मुव्हिंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन दॅट एंटायर सिवेज इज मुव्हिंग इन दिस डिरेक्शन काय होतं की हा एरिएटर एरिएट करत असताना सर्फेस एरिएटर येतो त्या मासला व्हॉल्यूम ऑफ दॅट सिवेज इज बिंग पुश्ड इन फॉरवर्ड डिरेक्शन अँड अगेन दिस इज ऑल्सो मेकिंग दॅट टू पुश फॉरवर्ड इन पुश दॅट सिवेज इन अ फॉरवर्ड डिरेक्शन Then it will go to the secondary clarifier and then sedimentation and separation can be performed. Okay, I will explain more with another one figure. You just try to understand it. See here, you can see another one figure. A shallow pond is constructed and here instead of by the surface aerator, aeration can be performed by diffuse aerator. डिफ्यूज एरिएटर म्हणजे कसं की तो बॉटमला पाईप सोडलेले असतात ज्याला होल असतात आणि इकडून कॉम्प्रेस एअर पाठवली जाते मग त्या होलमधून एअर बाहेर यायला सुरुवात होती या अशा होलमधून एअर बाहेर यायला सुरुवात होती अँड दॅट एअर विल मेक दॅट सिवेज इन अ सस्पेन्शन फॉर्म विच इज प्रेझेंट ओव्हर हिअर
as well as it is providing oxygen to this particular sewage. Okay, I think you understood. You are understanding. Okay, before I go to the explain. Okay, I have explained it, and at the same time I have written here for further understanding. So I will read this. Oxidation leads is an extended aeration activated sludge process that I told you. It is a kind of activated sludge process. This can be developed for a small cities. The sewage is aerated by surface rotor placed across the channel. Put it over like surface aerators placed across the channel. You can see here, these are the aerators. Here also, this is aerator. Here also, this is aerator. We have placed across the channel. Okay. Then the rotor entrains the necessary oxygen into the liquid and keep the content of the ditch mixed and moving position. काय ठेवायचं आपल्याला? Suspension form मध्ये टिकवून ठेवायचं. So the rotor entrains the necessary oxygen into the liquid and keep the contents in the ditch in a mixed and moving position. Okay. ते मूविंग पोझिशन मध्ये ठेवतो म्हणजे काय सस्पेन्शन फॉर्म मध्ये ठेवतो. इट इज पॉसिबल इन ऑक्सिडेशन ब्रिज. दे आर डिझाइन टू इम्पार्ट अ वेलॉसिटी ऑफ 0.3 टू 0.4 मीटर पर सेकंड. त्या एरिएटरची वेलॉसिटी किती असली पाहिजे? इट शुड बी इन द रेंज ऑफ 0.3 टू 0.4 मीटर पर सेकंड. देन द रोटर्स शुड रोटेट with an average speed of 75 rpm. Okay, that is also defined. So please note down this theoretical part, so I cannot dictate. Please note down. बोला तो okay, last 1 minute, less than 1 minute is remained over here. So until that you can continue with this slide, then we'll go to the next session, last session.